Good afternoon, one and all. My name is Dr. B. Srinivasulu, Department of Mechanical Engineer. Today we are going to discuss about the modern machining and forming method. So today we are knowing the machining process, classification machining process. Already in a last semester we have discussed of a metal cutting. Okay, another one is a grinding, another one is a unconventional, the modern machining method is there. Okay, so now we are discussing about the modern machining and forming methods here. Now, what is going on in the modern machining? So today technology is very advanced in industries like automobiles, industries, nuclear reaction plants. Okay, so what is going on? It means there is a development of material which have a high strength, okay, to a weight ratio, like of it may be a high strength of a temperature or it may be a resistance alloys are there. So here the material which has a highest specific of a strength, okay, it may be a carbon fiber or it may be a glass fiber, composite materials, okay, titanium it may be a aluminium, it may be magnesium, which is having a high steel of alloy. So it is a no longer possible to machine the tool material like which are very strong and hard. We have previously in a last semester we have discussed in a metal cutting that the tool is a contact with the workpiece. Okay, so for the lightweight, this tool should be very strong and the work material is a lighter weight. What happened? There is a tool is a contact with the workpiece and removing in the form of chip. That is a metal cutting process. Here in a modern machining, tool is not contact with the workpiece. This is some form of energy is required. So means it is act as a, here it is act as a tool. Okay, I want to prepare one tool. It is a very strong. So we are using a modern machining techniques here. Okay, means we are not using any sharp cutting tool in this one. We are using a some form of energy. It may be mechanical, it may be chemical, it may be electrochemical, electrical discharge. So that is a depend upon the work material we are going ahead. So now coming to the here. So what is a course objective? If I say of a course objective of a subject is, first thing we are knowing the importance of unconventional of a machining, that is a modern machining. Okay, and here the what is the working principle of various modern machining. I said of a, it may be a ultrasonic machine, it may be a electrical discharge machining, it may be a abrasive jet machining, it may be a water jet machine. That is a different types of working principle of various of a modern machining and a forming process here. And another one is a, what are the advantages, limitations, applications. So we are studying the objectives of all the things, and according to that one we are going for the, what are the process parameter for different machine having a different process parameters here. So for the to perform a various process, so that is the reason to know the suitable of a process for various engineering of a material and applications. So that is the reason we are going for the different machining for different process parameter for different application. Okay, I can use the same application in automobile, in the same application I can't use in the industries, I can't same thing in a aerospace. So different methods we are using, different process parameter using, and different applications we are using. Okay, according to the material. Okay, so these are the for the subject of a course objectives here. Now for the every objective there will be outcomes are there. So now if I say of outcomes, means here the understand the evaluation and the classification, means what are the needs of a non-traditional, means modern machining of a technology in a modern manufacturing here. Means according to the our manufacturing, day by day our manufacturing get increases here. So due to that one we are using a different types of technologies here. So this is the method is a, we are using of a modern machining, means we are using a some form of energy instead of a directly of a sharp cutting tool. Okay, this is a of a non-traditional of a machining of a technology here. In the same manner we are knowing the what is the principle, description, parameter, just now I said of a effective of a process of a performance and metal removal of a mechanism of a ultrasonic machining, abrasive jet machining, water jet machining, abrasive water jet machining here. So understand the principle and action and the parameters of effect of the same thing of a electrical discharge EDM, electrical discharge machining EDG, ECM, CHM, this all thing, electrical discharge, electro discharge machining and electrical discharge grinding also, electrochemical machining, this all process are take place in this one. Even for knowing the same thing, laser beam machining, LBM, EBM, PAM means laser beam machining, electric beam machining and plasma machining. So this all things are taken. So common method is that we are using some form of energy. We are not using any type of a, say, a sharp cutting tool in this subject. Comparing the conventional high energy of a rate flow of rate forming of a method here, and knowing the what is the principle and the applications of various types of high energy rate we forming. Example, let's we discuss, if I say some difference of a what is a conventional machining process and a modern machining process here, unconventional machining process here. If a conventional, previously we have discussed, means what happened compared to this one, now our modern machining, so there is accuracy is very less in a conventional machine. Accuracy is very less. Here the accuracy is very very high in this one due to of some form of energy here. Okay, and here the what happened, tool and the workpiece are physically contact. Just now I said of a if a tool is a workpiece is a physically contact, means tool should be have to contact with the workpiece here. That is a conventional machine. Here no physical contact is take place in a unconventional machining process. We are using some form of energy. We can say also sometimes we are using abrasive of a particles here. That is for removing the material here. Here we are using in a conventional machining process, we are saying there is a low surface finish in a conventional. Here the what happened in a modern machining process, we are using of a better surface finishing. That's the comparing also. And here in a conventional machining process, we can say all types material cannot be machined here. If we example, we can take that all type of a material cannot be machined by using of a convention of a metal cutting process. It's not possible here. But here in this one of a unconventional of a machining, almost all type of material can be machined. We know that one 90% of a with the form of energy, we can go into a machining process can be removed here. Okay. And in a conventional machining process, it is very difficult to produce a complex of a shape part. We know that one. For the single point cutting tool, if you use of a internal, very difficult. But here for the what happened, complex to complex, we can easily produce by using some form of means of an unconventional machining process here. And here, example, by using of a conventional machining process, not possible to drill a very small hole. We know that one. If we take off a lathe machine or other process here, what happened here, even for the drilling machine also, small hole, if I want to produce in a one component, it is not possible in a conventional. But in a, it is a small holes up to, we can imagine, we can make a hole up to 0.1 mm diameter can be machined by using of a modern machining methods here. That is the beauty of this one. And here, but only the one problem is that here is a conventional machining is a higher metal removal can be rate can be taken place here in a by using of a conventional. But compared to the unconventional machining process is low material removal, because by using a former it will be removed by little bit only, not very high like of a chip. Okay. And but another one is a disadvantage is a conventional process is the what happened, the cost is of equipment is very less while coming compared to the this one of unconventional machining process. Okay. To make efficient use of modern machining, if I am saying, is a necessary to know the exact nature of machining problem. So if I want to remove at the corner only by using of unconventional, by using of a conventional, not possible at the corner. What happened, it will get break here. So by using of this unconventional method, we can use at a complex to complex, we can remove here. That is the first we have to know what is the exact nature of the machining problem. Another one is that this method cannot be replaced. This type of a method which we are using of a unconventional of a methods, It cannot be replaced by using of a conventional machining process here. And a particular, if I say, of a machining of a method which forms of a suitable under a given conditions may not be equally efficient under those conditions. Example, if I says, what are the things are there means here, physical parameters and property of material, if I says of a process capability, economical consideration. These are the problems are there. Now coming to the, here is a, see, if I says of a silver, see here, now coming to the silvers here, the first unit is concerns of a, here is a need for non-traditional of a machining process selection, what are the classification, and I said of a, there is a ultrasonic of a machining process, abrasive jet machining, water jet machining, so abrasive water jet machining. So this we are studying about what are the means principle, working principle, and their applications, their parameter, the limitation, their advantage, and their limited and their disadvantages. We are knowing about that one. Okay. Now coming to this one. Now see here, second it is the same thing. Electro discharge machining, EDM, and a wire EDM, electro discharge grinding, electrochemical machining, electrochemical of. Okay. We are knowing the different types of a machining. Okay, first and second and third and fourth and fifth. So here the third end of a laser beam machining, that is the LBM, PA, plasma arc machining, and electron beam machining, and a high, if I fourth of it is a high energy rate of a forming here, electro hydraulic of a forming here, so electromagnetic forming here, rubber pad of a forming here, so stretch of a forming here. According to the our here modern machining and the forming method, three unit we are of machining and the another fourth and fifth unit are is in a forming method. Okay. Now compared to this one is a, now we just start our introduction. What is actually the modern or a non-traditional of a machining of a process here? If I say of a modern and a non-traditional of a manufacturing of a process here, see here. So what is going on here? Here process is defined as a group of process that remove excess of material by using of a various of techniques of a involving of a mechanical, thermal, electrical, chemical combination of this, that is the electrochemical we can also say. And but see here the point is, but do not use a sharp cutting tool as it's need to be used for a traditional machine manufacturing process. Just now I said the modern machining process or a non-traditional or unconventional machining, three terms are same only. So what is here, we are saying that we are using, if we want to remove excess of material from the workpiece, we are not using any type of a sharp cutting tool. We are using some form of energy. It may be mechanical, it may be thermal, it may be electrical or chemical or combination of electrical and chemical. These are the things. The extremely hard and the brittle material are difficult to machine by conventional means, we are saying that is a traditional machining process. Just now we discussed also, such as a turning, drilling, shaping, milling. This all things can be done by using of a non-traditional machining process, also called an advanced manufacturing process also we can say. That is the beauty of our subject is that, which cannot be, means we are not using is any type of a sharp cutting tool. Okay, there will be no physical contact between the tool and the workpiece here. And we are using some form of energy, for the complex to complex of a material can be removed with a good surface finishing. That is a, our modern or non-traditional manufacturing process we are saying. Very hard frequently material difficult to clamp or traditional machining when the work is too flexible or slender, when a shape of the part is too complex. Okay. Now if I am saying here, see, several types of a non-traditional of a machining process have been developed to meet extra required of a machining conditions. Even we have seen means here, where is a commonly described here. Okay, previously also it is started in 1940s. Because that one, because we have a discussed about so many of even for the pistons also sometimes what happened with the chemical of electrical discharge machining. These all things can be even the tool. we could not able to by using of a CNC machine, so it is could not able to do that one. So prepare one tool with a back rake angle setup. So that tool can also be prepared by using of a method of a non-traditional of a machining process here. And the high of a means if a tool is a made up of example of a carbide, is a very high strength. So what happened? Not possible by using of a machining process of a traditional machining process. So we are using a non-traditional machining of a process here. Modern manufacturing processes are classified according to the type of fundamental. That is depend upon the there some form of energy we can say. Okay, the basic point is here is a mechanism is a metal removal and the source energy is required. Okay, example I have given here. Classification of machining process, type of energy, mechanism of metal removal, and that is if I say is of a transfer of a media, energy source, and the process here. If I am saying it is a mechanical, type of mechanical is a mechanical, another one is a electrochemical, chemical, thermoelectrical, means here the mechanism of metal removal is erosion here by using of a mechanic, means of an ultrasonic machine we can also say that is a erosion or a shear. What is in an ultrasonic machine, that is a shear can be means abrasive slurry can fall onto the workpiece and it will make of a whatever the required of a shape here. Okay, here the abrasive jet machining, here water jet machining, that also comes in a mechanical. Okay, now transfer media, it means high velocity practical particles and the physical may be a contact here. Okay, and if energy source is a pneumatic or hydraulic pressure and cutting tool, we are using of a mechanical. See here, from the abrasive jet machining, ultrasonic machining and a water jet machining, all things take place in erosion here. Shearing is a conventional machining process, that is also a mechanical energy type. Electrochemical is a ion displacement, means due to electrolyte. Okay, what happened here, electrochemical machining and a electrical chemical of a grinding also. What happened due to some form of energy take place here, what happened due to ionizing. Due to ionizing, what happened? The removal of a material can be take place from the work material. It is take place in a total bath. Okay. If a chemical means ability of a relation, reactive environment, corrosive agent. Okay. Chemical of a, we can say the chemical of a machining also same. Thermoelectrical, fusion, vaporization, hot gases we can use, electrons we can use, radiations we can use, ion of a steam means ionizing of a material, high voltage, amplifier light, and different types of it. Maybe if I say of a ion beam of a machining here, of a plasma arc of a machining, electrical discharge of a machining here, even electron discharge of a machining, and laser beam of machining, different types of techniques. See here, according to the AJM, they are given the abbreviation. This is abrasive jet machining, CHM is a chemical machining, electrochemical of a machining, ECM, electrochemical of a machining, ECG, okay, electrochemical of a grinding. There are the different of WJM, water jet. These all things are take place of your abbreviation. Now coming to the very just is a introduction of the what is the ultrasonic machining. If I am speaking about that one, okay. So what is the ultrasonic of machining? So that is a we are in term we are saying a USM from the diagram. See here how the high frequency of oscillation is take place here, and there is a slurry, which is a slurry is a made up of abrasive particles. You have seen that abrasive particles in our grinding wheel also, that is the abrasive particles are there. In here also slurry is abrasive particles. It may be aluminium oxide, it may be silicon oxide. Okay, and the flow here and the workpiece here. Okay, high frequency of oscillation is there. That is the tool we are saying. See here, ultrasonic of a machining, mainly which principle it works. We know that one is a metal removal process, but in which principle, if I say here, is a work under the principle of piezoelectric or magnetostrictive effective. Piezoelectric or magnetostrictive effect. Okay, these are the basic two principle on that one. Ultrasonic machining is works. Okay, and the very basic of a ultrasonic of a machining involves a tool. You know, this is a tool. From this one, see here, there is a tool is going on here. Okay, the tool is made up of ductile or tough material, because it should be a withstand of that slurry. Means what happens, that oscillation, the tool should be striking on the abrasive particle. Okay, and abrasive particle is striking on the workpiece. So the tool should be very strong compared to this slurry of abrasive. So it is a very tough material and vibrating with a very high frequency. Means I written here in a, from the diagram, high frequency oscillation here. Okay. So vibrating with a very high frequency and continuous flow of an abrasive means the slurry is falling on that one. See here from that one, from this diagram, see here. Slurry of a machining can be continuously flowing here. And from this is a transducer of a horn. What happened here? This horn is nothing but is a moving downwards. So continuously oscillation can be taken place. Okay. So here a very high frequency and continuous flow of abrasive slurry in the small gap between the tool and the, this is a tool, from the tool and the workpiece here. In between the slurry is take place here. Okay. So there is a tool and the workpiece. So here the tool is gradually feed in a uniform force. The tool is gradually feed with a uniform force here. Means oscillation can be taken place at uniform only. Okay. Uniform force only, it is a moving of oscillation can be taken place at a uniform only. Okay. The impact of hard and abrasive grains fracture the hard and the brittle work surface. Then carefully here. Means here what happened? The tool is gradually feed with a uniform force. Okay. Uniform force, the impact of the hard and the abrasive grains, which is a fracture the hard and the brittle of it. Means whatever the here surface, it is impact on that one. Okay. In the same manner, which is a tool is a contact with the abrasive is a contact with the means of a workpiece. So what happened? Resulting in the form of removal of material. Okay, in the form of small piece of material can be removed from the workpiece here. Okay, the oscillation of a means here the horn is nothing but a, here is a tool is a hitting on the slurry is hitting on the workpiece here. So with a constant uniformly it is a forces impact on the slurry here, abrasive particles here, and abrasive particle is striking on the workpiece. So it is a removal of excess of material can be taken place. This is the simple concept of ultrasonic of a machining process here. So here means what is going on here? See here from the diagram. Ultrasonic machining is a mechanical metal removal process or an abrasive process used to eroded the holes or cavity on a hard and the brittle workpiece by using a shaped tool. Okay, there will be a different types of tools are there. It may be a cone, it may be a square. Okay, with a high frequency of a mechanical motion and abrasive slurry, and a USM offers a solution to an expanding need of machining of a brittle material such as a single crystal, or it may be glasses, or it may be polycrystal or ceramic, increasing the complex of an operation to provide a indicates of a shape and the workpiece profile. The hard particles in a slurry are accelerated towards the surface. Just now I said of a slurry, which is a hard particle, which is nothing but a, which is flows on the workpiece here. Just of a tool is if it is my workpiece here, it is my horn is there, tool is there. So slurry is already on the workpiece. So it is a striking on that one. Okay, on the abrasive particles of it. Tool oscillation at a frequency of means it can be oscillated up to 100 kHz. Okay, through a repeated of a abrasion. Repeatedly it is going on. Okay. Is a primary target to of a machining of a hard and the brittle material, just I have said, dielectric and a conductivity such as a boron carbide, ceramic, titanium carbide, rubics and the quartz. The following parameters need to be carefully considered. The machining tool must be selected due to their high wear resistance. Okay, and it may be such as a high carbon of steel we are using, that abrasive we are using of a that is depend upon the grain size. Okay. And the water base of a, okay, 40% of a solid volume, and slurry includes of a slurry, just now so abrasive particle is made up of a boron carbide, silicon carbide, aluminium oxide. See here from the diagram here, see the first we go with the here the slurry tank, slurry pump, slurry to a machining of a zone, feed motion, transducer, horn and the workpiece here, and the return of a slurry. So what is going on here? I am placing of a workpiece on the table. This is a horn which is connected to the transducer. I said the transducer mainly depend upon the piezoelectric and magneto stoichiometric effective here. So in this process, we are saying how it is going on. Means here we are converting. In this process, we are converting of a electric energy is converted into a mechanical vibration. Okay, we are saying of a this is a electrical. We are saying this is a two concept. Okay, which is nothing but a take place of a principle of a ultrasonic machining is piezoelectric or it may be a magnetosphere. Means here we are converting of a electrical energy is converting into a mechanical vibration. Electrical energy we are converting to mechanical vibration, and this purpose of a piezoelectric effect in a naturally, or we can say magnetizing can be exhibited by some metals in a utilization. We can also say okay. Now see here, how is it can be a, here the slurry means here this is a converted means we are supplying of a from a slurry tank, slurry pump, and slurry to a machining of a zone here. See here from the nozzle and just of a slurry, which is the abrasive particle which is flows on the workpiece. And the feeding means here there will be oscillation. Means oscillation can be a occur due to a piezoelectric or magnetostatic. It is a striking of a which is made up of horn here. Different types of horn can be taken place here. Horn is striking on the slurry, and the slurry is a strike on the workpiece. And whatever the requirement of a machining operation can be a done here. Okay. Now see here the equipment. If I say of equipment here, here. The basic mechanical structure of a ultrasonic is a very similar to a drill press. Already we see that one. Drilling machine. Same just like of this one also by seeing this diagram here. Okay. Slurry delivery and return system. Sometimes the slurry can be used by regain or sometimes we can't use. Depend upon the work force on the of a horn on the slurry. Feed mechanism to provide a downwards of a feed of a force on the tool during the machine. Just now of a this is my of a transducer. Transducer is connected with the horn. Horn is a nothing but a striking on the in a oscillation motion. Okay. The horn or a concentrated which is a mechanically amplify the vibration to a required amplitude of 15 to 50 micrometer, and that is a depend upon the what type of a slurry we are using and what of a distance should be there. That is the reason. Okay. I come to the tool at the tip. And what is the distance between a, when a tool is a contact with the of a slurry? See, this is the reason I said of a piezoelectric effect, magnetostrictive effect, and electrostrictive effect of a magnetostrictive transducer are most properly and a robust of a almost of a all. These are the equipment we are using. Now, if I am saying of a this is the means of a horn, okay, the horn, the tool, okay, how it is striking on that one, how is the coolant means how the power can be taken place. Just now I said. The electrical is converted to a mechanical of a vibration here. Okay, so how the vibration propagation can be taken with this of a generator power amplifier from the coolant in the horn and the tool. So there are the horn of a concentration with a wave of a guide. We can also say this is a typical diagram of a magnetostrictive transducer along with the horn here. Okay, so different types of a horn we can say that is a exponential taper or a stepper. Thank you. And this is the applications advantage and some disadvantage. If I am saying of application, the beauty of ultrasonic machining, it is can be make non-round shaped in a hard and the brittle material. Means here where is having a non-round or there, which can be easily can be made here. Okay, hard and the brittle here. And for the example, if I say here, see here. For the advantage, it may be any material can be machined regardless of their electrical of a conductivity, or it may be having a brittle of a material, or which is a better, which gives a better surface finishing, high structure of integrated. These are the things, and it ultrasonic machining does not produce a thermal, electrical, and chemical abnormal surface. It is not produces. Okay, only the disadvantage. And some more disadvantages in this one is here is a tool wear passed in a. Ultrasonic machine because the tool of a horn is directly contact with the abrasive, which is also very hard. So what happened that tool means here it will be very fast in a this ultrasonic of a machining, and machining area and the depth is resist in salt means there will be some limitation is there, so we can't move more that one. Okay, and lower material removal of a rate compared to the traditional, that also this every maximum of a unconventional machining process, this is only the disadvantage compared to the conventional machining process here. Okay, thank you. And have a nice day.